happy dawning, Guardian.
What's up, guys? My name is Matt, and yesterday, Bungie, as well as many other outlets such as IGN and Game Informer, released a mountain of information relating to the dawning Destiny's new winter event coming on December 13th. For those interested, I'll be linking the trailer, as well as a few articles about the event down in the description, but for everyone else, let's dive in. Like my other videos, I'll be breaking the video into three parts: Exotics and Ornaments, Sparrow Racing League, and Strike Scoring and Strike Changes. So if you're interested in just specific parts, you can skip to the time shown. I will also not extensively be discussing the Dawning as an event itself, as most of Bungie's holiday events are pretty straightforward, but I'm certain you guys are ready for me to shut up, so let's talk about Exotics and Ornaments. First, let's take a look at the exotics we already have and their new ornaments. For the Black Spindle, we have two new ornaments. That's this one, called Between Stars, and this one, called Ragabone. For the last word, we also are getting two new ornaments. The first one called Addendum, and the second one called Sequel. And I personally didn't post a video on it, but I'm certain you guys saw it. Back during the Festival Loss, there was a leak of one of the Thorn ornaments called Rose of Acid. And Bungie has tweaked that ornament, and this is what it looks like now. But this isn't all for the exotic changes. We're also getting three new exotics. Well, I shouldn't say three, I should say two, because one of those is an old exotic, and it should get some of the year one players incredibly hyped. So first, let's take a look at the two new exotics coming with the event. Many of us, including myself, have speculated how to get the Solar and Void versions of the Thunderlord. And the answer to that, during the Dawning event and afterwards. This is the Nova Mortis, the Void version of the Thunderlord coming with this event. And this is Abaddon, the Solar version, both obtainable through exotic quest coming on December 13th. But we aren't done yet. I'll let you year one players look at the screenshot for a second, and I'll let you figure out what the third exotic is. That's right, the Icebreaker is finally making its return, and it's coming with two new ornaments as well. Nanohance, the white theme ornament shown in this screenshot, and Dunemaker, shown now. This alone is a lot in terms of anything we've seen from Destiny recently, but that's only the exotics. Let's take a look at Sparrow Racing League. In addition to 11 new Sparrow designs and the two tracks from last year, Bungie is adding two new tracks. Shining Sands, which takes place on Mercury, and Harkin's Precipice, which takes place on Earth. In addition, unlike last time, Bungie is allowing for SRL gear to be infused, so if you want to run around Destiny's universe looking like a NASCAR driver, you now can. Also, I'd like to include that once the Dawning event ends, SRL will remain part of the game in private matches. And the last addition is a new game mode, or at least a tweak, called Strike Scoring. This applies to all playlists, the SIVA Crisis playlist, the Heroic SIVA Crisis playlist, and even Nightfalls. And it's even been mentioned that Nightfalls are your ticket to get the new Icebreaker through bounties. And these new bounties are given out by Commander Zavala, and are said to not be much different than the bounties handed out by Varix for Challenge of Elders. And if all this, everything that I mentioned before, the new exotics, the new ornaments, Sparrow Racing League, the event itself, Bungie has taken it even a step further, and is also adding three new SIVA variants to Strikes. Three are the Shadow Thief, the Will of Crota, and the Nexus. So if fighting Tanix or Omnigul with SIVA-fied enemies is something you wanted to do, you'll have that chance soon. But as I said, you didn't hear me wrong, the Nexus is finally making its return in Year 3, and Bungie is even bringing the Relic from the Vault of Glass as an added mechanic during the boss fight. There's a lot coming on the 13th, guys, and you can bet when it comes to my channel, there will be projects focused around the new content coming. I'd also like to shamelessly ask you guys to hit that like button, since YouTube has changed its algorithm and just watching my videos simply isn't enough anymore, apparently. So hit that like button for me.
You don't have to do that, unless you feel that it's deserved. By the way, I just think it's stupid that YouTube changed this, and this is sort of my way of venting about it.
I'd also like to remind you guys that there is a sub-Discord provided to me by my friends over at Multilux, so if that's something you're interested in, link in the description, as well as I want to thank you guys for watching the video. But that's all I got for you guys for now, so I'm going to get out of here, say my name is Matt, and I'll see you guys next time.